art, to me, explores what it means to be human. Whether it's in engineering, science, business, design, architecture, planning, all of us need to explore deeply what humanity means in our different given fields.
There's a super long history of amazing arts at MIT. We're trying to create polymath designers that can become biological designers and computational designers or physicist designers, anything creative, and we want to tap into that at MIT. Like, CAST is the place to do it.
Part of what's so powerful about the kind of interdisciplinary classes that CAST supports, it takes away some of the comfort of relying on things that are familiar and challenges people to work, to think, create, and experience in new ways. Most of the disciplines that students study at MIT are very rational, but rationality always has an irrational dimension. Paranormal Machines was an interdisciplinary class that sought to bring together anthropological and artistic approaches to investigating experiences of the paranormal. And what the students were seeking to do in this work was to create experiences of the transcendent that serve as a lever to look out and contemplate from a higher plane the significance of our lives in the world.
We're using a lot of technology, and we were trying to find that threshold between something that a human could recognize, but also wasn't totally sure what it might be or what it might be trying to say. And that threshold is really difficult to find.
We're learning a lot about how people take their own ideas and make new ones based on their past experiences and what their perceptions are.
A class like Paranormal Machines complements the educational mission of the Institute by giving students an opportunity to reflect critically and creatively on what science and technology do in these students' lives.
Hussein Chalayan, his body of work has looked at transformation and reconfiguration and material intelligence and new technologies, and that really works hand in hand with the self-assembly lab. And that led to this idea of a collaborative studio. The vision of the intelligent skin class was to push beyond devices slammed into garments and clothing, but really what is intelligence and how can that connect, respond, sense, and sort of amplify human experience.
We're probably all familiar with lint, which is what we remove from our dryers. And it is literally the eroded particles and bits of our clothing. I wanted to bring those eroded bits back to create a material that could then shape a new garment.
I picked TPU as the material and 3D printing as the fabrication process. And the challenge, though, was getting a traditional 3D printer to work with these materials. I think the very idea of being able to take a relatively flat or minimal surface and getting a kind of volume out of it, it's a very interesting prospect, not just for fashion, but for architecture.
I teach students from engineering, design, architecture, and business how to ask whether they can design with equity and justice in mind in their particular fields. Professor Eyer also explores something similar, how to train actors, performers in musical theater to consider the relationship between society and justice in the theater itself.
We spent a lot of time in the fall going through background materials on various topics.
Black experiences, female experiences, and queer experiences.
The intersection kind of STEM and the arts.
I think the bedrock of what we're doing is, yeah, here's the research, but how do we present it in a way that is going to be unexpected to the person walking in? How do we take that research from graphs and from paper and turn that into something experienced and lived?
I am not a commodity, a machine, not something to buy, something to breathe.
Oftentimes we're trying to achieve something that's really, really challenging. I don't think you can solve that with one silo. You know, you're not gonna engineer your way out of it. How do we make these challenging problems become possible? I don't think it's just one discipline and one technical solution. You need to be able to switch between the creative and the technical to challenge some of these big issues.